Another power-packed spacewalk outside the space station, highlighting a pretty cool comet. And a key piece of space launch system hardware is on the move. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. Our Chris Cassidy and Bob Behnken were back outside the International Space Station on July 16th to outfit one of the station's power channels with new lithium-ion batteries and associated hardware. The spacewalk is one of the few remaining in a 3.5-year effort to upgrade the station's power system. NASA photographer Bill Ingalls recently captured images of Comet NEOWISE in the early morning skies over Washington, D.C. The comet, which was discovered by and nicknamed after our NEOWISE spacecraft, has been visible at certain hours with the naked eye and has been spotted by several NASA spacecraft as well as astronauts aboard the space station.
The fact that we can see it is really what makes it unique. It's quite rare for a comet to be bright enough that we can see it with the naked eye or even with just binoculars. The last time we had a comet that was this bright was Comet Hale-Bopp back in 1995 and 1996.
Comet NEOWISE is expected to make its closest approach to Earth on July 22nd. On July 17th, teams at our Marshall Space Flight Center in Huntsville, Alabama, put the wheels in motion to transport the launch vehicle stage adapter for our Space Launch System rocket to our Kennedy Space Center in Florida in preparation for the first uncrewed Artemis mission around the moon and back. The adapter, which connects the upper and core stages of the rocket, is being transported aboard the agency's Pegasus barge. On July 16th, the joint European Space Agency NASA Solar Orbiter mission released the mission's first data, captured during the spacecraft's first close pass of the sun. On that flyby last month, Solar Orbiter captured the closest images ever taken of the sun and had all 10 of its instruments turned on together for the first time, including an American-led instrument designed to pinpoint coronal mass ejections. We are now targeting October 31st, 2021 for the launch of our James Webb Space Telescope from French Guiana due to impacts from the ongoing coronavirus pandemic as well as technical challenges. Engineers recently conducted the first full systems evaluation on Webb since the telescope was assembled into its final form. It's a critical software and electrical analysis on the entire observatory as a single fully connected vehicle. Webb is the largest and most technically complex space science telescope NASA has ever built. The CALIPSO satellite, a joint venture between NASA and the French space agency CNES, helped provide a unique view of the massive Saharan dust plume that crossed the North Atlantic Ocean in June into parts of the U.S. The animation includes data and imagery from CALIPSO, a space-based laser that measures clouds and small atmospheric particles, and from National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration satellites. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.